lads. Well, first a quick explanation on this one. I did think I had six bags of latex for this one, but I only put on five bottles, so it's that's just to explain that one for a start. But I'm going to carry on with the rake though, and because I've got it, by the time I found out it was too late, you know, I'd already got it set up, so I'm going to get it done. So I thought, worst case scenario, if it does run tight to that side, I'm just going to drop the cam down to the next one and then just put it. I mean, the floors are white really for a 3mm, but to show you the best way to use these rakes, well, the camguage rakes, I'm not a big fan of the pin levers, to be honest, because you have to hold them at a certain angle for them to work. What makes the camguage different is it's just rounded, and that's all it is. But with it being round, it's, you can have it whatever height, you know what I mean? You're not restricted to holding it at a certain angle to get the height. But that's not, I mean, you get used to that anyway. I mean, setting three, I think, is a 5mm, so you work it out about 3 square metres a bag. You know, I hate talk through, so I'm just trying to cover everything. Yeah, so the main thing that happens between when you're going from trowel to using one of these, it's the same, I think, with everyone, is that you spend so long doing it with one mixes, you know, and a trowel, and you're trying to control it. You know, we're only putting enough on the floor to, you know, to think you can like overwork it like a trowel, and you're not going to get it right with the rakes if you do it that way. You've got to, once you get the confidence, you've just got to realise you've got to get as much on the floor as you can straight away before you get the rake out, and then do it. So you need the amount on the floor for it to work, you know, for you to pull it over. If you're trying to work it, it's not going to happen. So anyway, so we've got a 3 in there and a 2 in here. I'm going to get them both mixed up, to be honest with you, and then get everything out of the way, and then we'll go for it with the rake. So, alright. I've actually dropped the cam down to a 2 because I do know how accurate these things are, and if you set it on 3, you know, it'll only give me the 15 and a bit, and I do. So I've set it to the 2 so I can put it over and do it all in one. But as a rule, I like it on setting 3, so I do give a good 5mm coat on everything and flood it. But this is already had a few coats, so it can take it. Right, another thing that you do it anyway is, before you're mixing up, get all your bags out, but get all the tops off them and all of that not ready to go. The reason for that is with these, as you go so fast, you know, when you come to that last bit, you don't want to be opening bags, and it really is like it's a small little thing, but it does make a difference. So, without further ado, let's get it done. Sorry, let's grab me line. Before, so. Well, no, everyone wants to eat the grape mix, but you know, it doesn't mix. Nice to have the ones with the thingy buttons, so you can just leave it on, and you know, and while you're mixing, but like I said, mine's busted, so let's get the going. Show you this little bit, the first little dump out. Now, when you're going from the trowel and that lot, you're so cautious with how you're putting it in there when you're going to go to put it down. You just don't put enough down, so, you know, if you feed a little bit, and start getting all warm up and over and over, and let's just get this one all, let's just, and start mucking about with that. You're not going to get anywhere with it because it's just wearing off. There's nothing there straight away. You know, you've got to really, really overload it. So, you know, as the bucket gets a little bit less, you can do it in ribbons and that, not stop, but you just want to get it all there, get a load of it on the floor. You know, your idea is to get it right until the edges, and you can have your shoes on then, can't you? See it in front of it, you're right. You just, you know, if there's gaps there, then you know you're not, but that's all it is. You know, but if you didn't have enough there, you're not going to be able to do this. I mean, it's well deep there, so I'll be putting loads over. Just, you know, don't get in there. If you put it all masked up, you're going to feel alright. So then, since you've got it in there, then I'll just do the doormat bit. this, you know, it's been ages, and still getting around on it, but as I make, it's about, and after about half hour, you know, you're still going to be able to much work on this. But at the same time, it stayed wet enough for me working on your own, which is different, to have the time to mix fucking rake and then spiky roller. You've got to allow yourself, you know what I mean? Well, I couldn't do it on my own anymore. But on the bigger jobs, you really do need someone. And when you've got someone mixing for you, that person's got to understand a little bit, you know, it's just, their job is just as fucking important as the man with the rake, you know? If you're not feeding him at the right time and he's got to fuck about with it, then it all goes wrong. So, you know, get yourself on the same page. After a while, you'll be working with someone at the same time. You'd only have to say it the first time, wouldn't you? But you've really got to flow, you know? Think of it as like, if whoever's trailing out or raking out, and then if they've got to turn around and ask for a bucket, you've failed. If you haven't got one ready for them and got the other one out of the way, you fucking failed. So this is in no purposes. You've got to think like that. Just one last quick final tip. If you're using bag and bottle, which is like a bonus for it, if you don't, especially in the summer and that lot, because it does dry, you know, quick enough. Now, what we always used to do is like, just hang around until it's still green. But it's soft, and all you do is just put a straight edge over it everywhere and a couple of tapes out, and just it gives you an opportunity to clean any edges or get any of these discrepancies or, you know, any imperfections that you get while it's still green, you know. Otherwise, if you wait till they go off and on, they're a bastard, so you've got to rub them down. But you do it, your tape is cut out while it's green. I mean, it's winter now, and it's, you know, it's late, so, but it's probably taken about an hour and a half to get to this, nearly 2 hours, I suppose. But it's never usually, by the time you packed away or something, you know, you can find something to do. Just, it's worth to hang around, you know, because while it's soft, you know, if you put your tape off, if you've got it there, you won't get any of those little bits accidentally, or then basically, you know, any swells that you get around the edges, or if it's just not quite right, you just, you know, maybe pull your little straight edge over. But later on, found out it's called it's an old school trick. It was a fit on floor line, so back scratching, but you know, it's a good one though. Because it can take care of a lot of issues, you know, apart from the people who, you know, think that do the swimming pools and that lot, you go the next day and go straight on it, there's no such thing. Especially in the summer, because you know, rain has gone off, so you can get on it almost like within about half hour. But what I like about the off you go is it does give you enough time to work with it when you're on your own. This is a way to use 1200, but all of a sudden, you know, it started to cure too quickly, and there's it to you. So when you hit it the next day, you know, it's all cleaned and ready. See, if I had the extra bag of those pegs, I wouldn't even probably be doing half of this. You don't. The more you put down, obviously, the less work it's going to need. Jeff used to say, when I was showing pictures of like latex jobs and that, like looking like ponds and that, he never used to be impressed. He used to just say, "Yeah, mate, show me when it's drawn another rough." Right, only. That'll do, Sue.